First give Cebu, he scored 16 points, but JRU has keyed their defense on him. Of course, he's ready about it to step up.
And finally, Kindai makes it from the free throw line. He's 1 out of 4 from there. And a 5-point lead. Kindai only with 3 points in this game. Dangerous pass picked off here by Mark Balneg. Another dangerous pass almost picked up by the JRU Heavy Bombers, and his last touch by Jasul.
Yeah, Kagoko not giving up on that play, no? After that turnover, he gets it right back. And with 2:18 left, it's winning time, basketball fans.
And someone's season will come to an end.
Again, no, Marvin Hayes with difficulty getting that ball down.
Oh, this is going to be an 8-second violation. And again, I still don't understand why Ariel Vanguardia is putting Hayes in the backcourt.
All game long, he's had trouble bringing down that ball.
This is a chance. Yes, Rick.
It's a big turnover talaga, no? Because as you can see, Letran is just really hanging in there.
A chance now for Letran. A three-pointer will make this a two-point game. That's how close it is right now. JRU had an 18-point lead in the second quarter. Letran can partially erase that with his offensive thrust. Foronda thinking about the three. John Foronda drops it off.
West, for three.
What a shot! Asking for some pressure. Just a two-point lead now for JRU.
JRU's lead is now history.
Ah, a steal, but a foul in the backcourt. And that could have been big had that foul not been called on Rafael Azul. It could have been an easy layup there for Andrew Kindai.
But if you look at Coach Louis Alas, no, he's smiling. He likes the defensive intensity of Letran right now. No,
well, he knows finally. Whatever he told them in halftime is finally getting through to his boys.
Yes.
All they needed to do was believe, and they are actually one defensive stop away from tying this game up.
Don't look now, but Marvin Hayes has the ball.
Again, but this time Marvin Hayes gets lucky. Kagoko over to Dedicatoria. Dedicatoria, wow! Floyd Dedicatoria.
Ano yun, 11th point na ba niya?
He's got 15 actually. Ito si Floyd Dedicatoria. And Dedicatoria now with a chance to increase this lead.
Well, I guess it's really natural for JRU to go to their main man, no? Floyd Dedicatoria has come alive this second half.
After being so quiet in the first half, Dedicatoria's free throw, that's long, but it sneaks back in!
And that gives JRU a 5-point lead. 61-56 with 1:35 left in the game.
So in short, Rick, binawi lang nito si Dedicatoria yung three-pointer kanina ni Balneg. But Balneg has it right now, lowers his shoulder for the second time in this game. He's called for that kind of an offensive foul.
And look who got that foul of Balneg, J.M. Wilson.
J.M. Wilson has been quiet but efficient, as we keep on mentioning. And again, as we take a look at this last play, and naman si Wilson, Balneg dropping his shoulder. And we have a timeout, ladies and gentlemen, 61-56. JRU by 5 with a minute and 28 remaining in this ballgame. Only 1 minute and 28 seconds remaining in someone's Champions League season. Who will it be? Will JRU hold on for the win, or can Letran pull some more rabbits out of their hats? We'll find out in a minute and 28 seconds. Ito pa rin po si Noel Zarate alongside Rick Olivares and Mika Abisamis. Welcome to the Champions League, folks.
Well, what I like about this Champions League, no? Hindi lang yung mga Metro Manila teams na nakikita nyo. We see the Southern teams, the teams from the other leagues, and you know, it's not just about the hype for the NCAA and the UAAP. In fact, the teams from the other conferences, the other leagues, have done just as well.
Well, the University of Visayas did very well, eliminating Adamson University.
That's right.
Nobody saw that one coming. At ito ngayon, JRU, the last remaining wild card. Can they pull off another upset against the 2005 NCAA champions, Letran Knights?
I think that was a brilliant strategy on the part of Ariel Vanguardia to have Floyd Dedicatoria to bring down the ball.
Floyd Dedicatoria is actually a very good ball keeper, a ball carrier rather. Here's Kagoko, only 6 seconds on the shot clock. Going to Hayes. Hayes now has to do something with this. Hayes almost lost it, dropped it off. And here's a stretch, it will not count. A 24-second shot clock violation against the JRU Heavy Bombers. And again, pagpunta kay Hayes ng bola, dun nasira yung takbo ng opensa.
That's right.
We're not blaming Hayes for anything. I'm sure he's doing his best. But sometimes, when the ball just gets to Hayes, may nangyayari sa opensa ng JRU.
That's right. Kagoko should have taken the ball, and you know, he's the floor general for this team. He should have taken charge. He knows that, with all due respect to Marvin Hayes, he's trying his best. But right now, they need to put the ball in someone else's hands.
Luis Alas knows that this offensive thrust is key with 1:03 remaining. Azul being watched by Kagoko. Right now, Melegrito going over to Ray Guevara. Guevara has been stellar this game. That time he misses. Battles for the rebound. Picked up by Guevara once again. Guevara with the basket.
The lead down is 3 points, 61-58 with 45 seconds left in the game.
Dangerous inbound pass, fielded here by Wilson. Wilson lost his footing and he is upended there by Kim Dai and he looks hurt. Wilson hit his head on the floor.
Kim Dai is just really having a nightmare of a game. He's just all, he's only made one of four shots. There's only one field goal. He's been reduced to a non-factor in this game. In fact, Ray Guevara has had to pick up the scoring cudgels for Letran.
Ray Guevara has been stellar also for Letran, but now J.M. Wilson going to the free throw line. Both teams are in the penalty right now, with only 40.8 seconds remaining. This will give JRU a little bit of breathing room and make it a two-possession game. John Marion Wilson, 14 points, 9 rebounds, another great performance off the bench, and makes good on his first.
Yes, he gives the Heavy Bombers some breathing room with that free throw. But he has one more coming. He looks tuckered out, Noel.
And he's been playing actually without rest for this entire second half. Sinani Marvin Hayes. Second free throw is not there. 4-point lead. They do not need a 3-point shot yet. Ito ko po na ng Letran. Azul looking for Guevara. Guevara splits the lane once again. Out to Azul. Azul with the jumper. No, battles for the rebound. Foronda loses to Locum. And now Letran has to foul.
Kagoko down in the backcourt. He is fouled by Jazul.
And finally, Azul will be whistled for this foul. With 18.1, is it a possibility? Can JRU still be alive in the Champions League? And can they make it to the Final Four again?
What an incredible run so far, no? They finished 4-10 in the NCAA, and here they are up against Letran, who had the opposite. They had a 10-4 record.
You mentioned, Rick, 7-0 since 2001 against Letran.
Exactly. No, since 2003... Letran is owned JRU. They have a 7-game win streak.
That's
going.
That's right, since 2003. I've correct myself there.
Again, Kagoko. There are two things on the line right now.
Well, let's see if Letran can still pull off some kind of a minor miracle here. Overshot. Again, another rebound by Noko. And it looks like JRU 7 seconds away from making it to the Final Four. Dedicatoria. They don't foul him anymore, and they finally do, but it's a tap out. With only 8-tenths of a second remaining, and the JRU Heavy Bombers have done it again.
What an incredible win by JRU. They are the giant killers of this tournament so far.
And this just has to be an inbound, a formality of an inbound right here. And that will do it, ladies and gentlemen. The JRU Heavy Bombers are moving on to the Final Four. First upsetting the USC Heavy Tigers, the UAC champions, and now they upset the NCAA in 2005 champions, the Letran Knights. What an incredible Champions League run here for Ariel Baguante and the rest of the Heavy Bombers.
Exactly, Noel. No? JRU, so far they have been the story of this tournament. They have beaten UST and now Letran. They have not only ended the 7-game losing streak to Letran, but they're also in the Final Four. They have ruined Letran's dreams of making it to the Final Four after getting knocked out in the Final Four of the NCAA.
And remember, folks, that Letran has never made it to the Final Four of any Champions League that they have joined. They were eliminated by UP in the round of 16 last year. They made it to the round of 8 this year, but again, the wild card team, the last remaining wild card team, makes it to the Final Four as the JRU Heavy Bombers celebrate right now on the hard court. There's your final score, ladies and gentlemen, 64-58. And again, we have to credit it to the defense na inumpisa ni Coach Ariel Vanguardia in the first half. But before anything else, let's turn it over to Mika Abisamis right now. Mika.
Thank you, Noel. Okay, mukhang pinahirapan kayo nung letra nung halftime. Ano ba yung, ano, in-expect nyo ba na mahirapan kayo sa second half?
Oo, kasi yung mga big man nila malalakas, tapos sa mga defensa nila masyadong physical. Tapos nag-adjust kami, sabi ni Coach, gawin lang yung play namin para mabit yung letran.
So anong motivation ang ginawa nyo since alam nyo na papahirapan kayo ng letran sa second?
So sunod namin yung mga play ni Coach. Yung mga tinuturo niya, ayun.
So nag-work naman lahat ng play ni Coach mula nung bago pa kayo maglaro today?
Oo, yeah.
Congratulations, Noel!
Thank you very much, Mika, with our best player of the game, our ANTA best player of the game, Floyd Dedicatoria. Well, Rick, it's been a pleasure covering this game with you, but the day isn't done yet. The Ateneo de Manila Blue Eagles go up against the Mapua Cardinals.
Likewise, Noel, I've had fun working this game with you. And, well, about this game, it's what the Champions League all about is all about, second chances. And here we are in the next game, Ateneo de Manila versus Mapua, old-time NCAA rivals.
And we will have that for you with Jude Torquato and Alex Compton on behalf of Rick Olivares and Mika Abisamis. It has been Noel Zarate. Thank you for watching the Collegiate Champions League. JRU moves on to the Final Four. Keep it right here on Basketball TV.